If you're a virtual assistant or a business owner that is looking for how you can streamline your business operations, in today's video, I will be sharing with you project management tools that can help you to stay organized, boost your productivity, and keep your team together in one place.
If you're ready to work smarter and not just harder, stay tuned and watch this video till the end.
Welcome back to my channel. My name is Tokwe, and I am a virtual assistant. On this channel, I share tips and valuable information that can help you to start your virtual assistant business or grow your virtual assistant business and also start and scale your online business. So without wasting so much time, let's get into what we have for today. So in this video, particularly, I'll be talking about Trello, and in my coming videos, I will share other project management tools such as Asana, monday.com, ClickUp, and Notion. All right. So you can pick any of this project management tool and use depending on your individual needs or your business needs.
Welcome to Trello project management tool. So if you're new to using Trello, you just need to sign up. Of course, your dashboard is not going to look like this. You know, it's going to just be plain. Now, when you come to your dashboard, the first thing you want to create is your workspace. Of course, by the time you sign up, you will be directed to create a workspace from the beginning, or Trello automatically creates one workspace for you. So it's quite easy to create a workspace. So you can see the workspace that I have here, okay? So all you need to do is when you come to your account here, you can click on create workspace and follow the prompt to create your workspace. So when you are in your workspace, for example, I'm going to open up one of my workspaces for you, which is this, my personal business workspace. All right. So under this workspace, I have my boards. I have highlights, the views. So I have, I think there are two views here. So we have the table view and the calendar view. So the table view will just show you the card list and every other thing. Then the calendar view will show you, you know, dates of each of your tasks and due dates and, you know, every task based on their dates. All right. So let's go back to my workspace. So here is my workspace. Let me move down. So under your workspace is just like your office where you come together with your team member to collaborate on projects or on your work, okay? And you can also use it personally to organize yourself and your business, all right? So under your workspace, you will have your boards. So boards are just where you will create, you can organize your own task. So first of all, you have your workspace. Then under workspace, we have boards. Then under boards, we have cards, and we have lists, then cards. So these are just the hierarchy by which each of these things follow each other. So when you already have a workspace, in a workspace, you need to create a card. So the card will now, the boards will be for, you know, different things. For example, you can create a board for your marketing side of your business. You can create a board for projects. You can create a board for customers and all that, you know, and so on and so forth. So to create a board, you can start from create here. You can start from create here and click on create board. Then you will, you will title your board. You will choose your workspace and you will choose the visibility. If you want it to be visible to the workspace or you want it to be private, of course, you can create a private board where only you can just have access to it, so that other members of your workspace will not have access to it. Probably there are just some personal things or from private work you want to handle them. Then you can also create this from templates. So there are different templates that are available here on Trello that you can choose from. You can see a list here. So depending on what you want to do, this template just allow you to edit and make your work easier instead of starting from scratch to create something. So for example, now, if I want to create, let me see, a teaching weekly planning board. So I've just choose a template, all right? Then I'm going to click on create. So now that I've clicked on create, it will create So this is the board already. And you can see here, this one here now is a list. This is a list and this is a card. All these now are cards. You can see edit card, edit card. So this very one now is a list. You can see copy list, you know, move all cards in the list, right? Here is a list. But on each of this list is a card. So do you see it? We have this typical digital brand workspace, and we have this teaching weekly planning board. Then under this board, we have each of this list, then card. So we have beginning of the term, list. So under this one, we have different tasks that needs to be done here. So for example, reserve lab and so on. And so you can begin to edit it to what suits your needs. All right, you edit this, you edit this, you edit this, and when you are done, you can move out of this board. Okay, so you can create boards. There's a limited number of boards you can create under the free version of using Trello. All right, so you can use Trello to organize your business, your project, your entire business. If you're a virtual assistant and you're working with clients, you can help your client to use Trello to organize their business, also to streamline their work and manage their team members, customers, and all that. So there's a lot that you can actually do. So go ahead and just explore Trello. Okay, you can invite members into Trello. Yes. So to invite members, just click on your workspace. You can invite members to your workspace. And also, if you're a virtual assistant, your clients or the person you're working with can invite you to join their workspace so that they can, you know, assign tasks to you. All right. So each of these boards, you can be able to assign tasks to a member that is under your workspace. So if I have someone in this workspace and some of these tasks, I want them to handle it. So all I need to do is to just click on this task or the card, and I can say open the card up to see more functions. You know, this other one is just like a shortcut. The other one, this one, I open it up. So you can add members here. Click on members, then you will search for the member. You know, just because I'm the only one on this card, that is why it's showing just me. So if you have already added other members, you will see the list here. Then you can choose them to add it to this board, to this particular task. Okay. Under this task, you can add labels. So labels can help you to show the level of importance or urgency of your task, or to identify if the team member, the work has been done or the work is still in doing process. Okay, so you can use cards to identify this. You can use label to identify this. You can also add checklists. So for example, under this this very card, this task to reserve labs special room. So there are other things that you still want to add. You want to break it down onto a like a sub task. So you can use checklist to add it. So just click on checklist, you type it in, then you click on add. And when the checklist has been done, you can tick it as done. All right. So you can add as many as possible. Of course, there is a limit to what you can do in this free plan. So you can add a date to this work. For example, maybe a due date or a date where someone will be notified. So I can put this date. Okay. And click on save. So you can see that it's telling me that this work is still soon. Okay, you can add a cover just to, you know, give it a form of visual representation. All right. So there are quite a number of things you can do here for each of your card. For each of your card, you can add attachments. You can move this card from here to another card. For example, I can try to move this to something else. Maybe, let me see, the next one. Or something else entirely from this board, you know, just to show that probably this work has been done and you want to pass it to another department. Okay, so when you are done with everything you want to do, you can then go back to your, you know, just click on the close button. So these are ways by which you can edit your card and your board. All right, so now I just show you how to edit one card. So you can just go ahead and play around this thing, all right? Play around it to schedule, to manage your task and your activities.
You've seen how you can use Trello as a project management tool. What are you waiting for? This is a time for you to streamline your activities, your tasks, your operations. You don't need to get stressed or overwhelmed with tasks, with your business operations. Go ahead and use Trello. Trello is quite friendly, user-friendly, beginner-friendly, okay? So you can get started right away. And if you have any question, drop it in the comment section. I will do my best to attend to your question. Don't forget to like this video. Drop your comments and share with your friends. Subscribe if you're a new member. And I will see you again in my next video. You need to watch out for the next video because I will be talking about the other project management tool. So you don't want to miss that video.